Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. Look, one thing about me, I'm going to look good when I step out of the house. I'm going outside for a little shopping, maybe get some french fries or something, a smoothie, and I must look good, baby.
Go Cinderella, go Cinderella. Orgasm, blush, lipstick, gigacilla. Devil in a tight dress, girl, you a killer. And ain't nobody realer, and ain't nobody realer. Go.
So this is what I'm wearing, a bra and this sheer panties from Fashion Nova. It's actually like a two-piece. It comes with a sheer dress, but I like wearing it like that. I don't like it under the dress, so I made it a regular underwear. And this bra, this is one of my favorite bras. It's really great quality. I love the details. It's amazing. And of course, I have been looking after my body. I've been looking after my body, and I would say I have really tried and learned how to maintain my weight. I was really overweight at some point and very insecure about my body and whatnot, but looking at myself in this mirror right now, I can see and appreciate that I really do have, you know, what it takes to maintain discipline, and I'm proud of myself for that, period. So I'm gonna go dress. I'm not sure what I'm gonna wear for this vlog anyways, but I'm going to wear something. And these are my undergarments, because I really do wanna do something. I don't know, I might do a makeup or I might do something, just something, but I do need some makeup on this face. And then when I'm done, you guys will see. Yeah, but my body is looking good and I'm proud of myself for maintaining a healthy diet and routine, because this is me. I've eaten dinner. I've had dinner and like my stomach is not looking that big. Can you see? I'm proud of myself, period. So let's get into it. I hope you guys are going to enjoy this one, because I really, really, really miss talking to you guys and doing all the stuff that I usually do. So, bye.
And I know y'all like hearing my voice, so I'm gonna give it to y'all. This banana smoothie, I've shown you guys before on previous vlogs. Y'all know it's my favorite. Okay, period. And then, bitch, when it comes to good food, me, I love a good African meal. And I'm saying African because this is spread across. Bitch, I lied. It's some stupid ass french fries. Anyways, the french fries were not that bad. At least they were seasoned, so I enjoyed eating them without ketchup. Because me, one thing about me, I'm not a fan ketchup user. Like, I don't like ketchup. Like, as long as the fries is seasoned and well salted, I'm good. Here we are.
I really do have to do much. Like, do you, when you watch American YouTubers, do you see them posting every day? Do you see them posting 3 vlogs in 1 week? No, they don't, because they're making money, these people, guys. They really are. Like, YouTube is a side hustle for them. I don't want to talk to them. So if you're gonna be in South Africa, you wanna do YouTube, trust me, you have to do it because you love it. Don't do it because you think you're rushing for the money. The money's not gonna come now. Trust in me, the money's not gonna come now.
Sai kuna mlio na watch vlog na shangaa ni chai inapikwa ni ugali ni mchele ni nini imagine ya nini wewe mlio ambaye unatazama runinga. I will tell you shortly ni nini. You guessed it, ni aka ugali. We acha nikwambie, hii sapa ya leo inaenda kuweza inaenda kushika. Sorry, simu ilishika nini steam, so I had to wipe it. But aka ugali kangu ni kamtoka moja, niko solo and I'm really hungry. And this is my dinner. So mimi ndio huyu nikageuza geuza akaka ugali. I'm making this small ugali to go with some nice veggie stew that I made, which you guys are gonna see in the next slide. Eh, hey, jameni, mbaba uko wapi jameni? Natafuta mbaba ambaye atakuwa anakuja kwangu kula chakula safi, chakula tamu. Mnaona hiyo mboga? Can you see that veggie? Eh, hey, this one has matumbo and the veggie is dodo. If you don't know what dodo is, it's called amaranth. If you don't know what amaranth is, go back to school, please. Aibo. Anyways, mbabas, back to the mbaba topic. There is my kaugali kanaivaiva. The ugali is ugaliing. The ugali is so small. Like nowadays I eat such small portions and I still get fat. I don't even understand my body. But whatever. Trust the process. Trust the process. Anyways, mbaba, if you're watching this, welcome to my kitchen. Kwa jikoni yangu, I do my thing. I cook my cooking. I do my thing. Nobody taught me how to cook like this. I like to cook my... Especially if it's meat, I like to put a little bit of vegetable inside. And then some pili pili. If you don't know what pili pili is, it's chili. Yes, so there is my presentation. I've put my ugali on the plate there. And then I have my matumbo chilling on the side, which I'm about to plate. Nakwambia, ooh! The smell of this thing is magical. It's aromatic. It's romantic. It's everything. Ni akutwanyoka pangoni, jameni. Ah! Look at my presentation. It's not the best presentation. Me, I'm not an influencer. I don't even know what aesthetics is. Lakini mi bora chakule iko kwa sahani. Itaingia tumboni. Na itadajistiwa na itanipatia nguvu. Then, after dimbuaing the ugali with the matumbo, I decided to just have a mango. Ah!
Been a few hours, but it felt like days. Only been days, but it felt like months. Only gone for a year, only know like months. Life moves fast when you do what you want. I guess I'm doing what I want. Hope you do.
There's my noodles. Cooking politely. As I wait to recover from my hangover, this is what I like to eat in the morning. I have spicy noodles, very spicy. I just make mine very simple. You guys know this is a very simple recipe, nothing complicated. Looks like I need to add some water. Yeah, I need to add some water because it does not look cooked to me. You know, as long as it's still like that, it means it's very far from cooked. So I'm gonna add some more water. A little bit more because I want it to be like soupy. I need the soup.
What I'm trying to say is, I don't like it when somebody comes up to me and tells me, oh my God, you've changed so much. That is the point. Like every freaking 5 years, I'm a different person. Like life is going, time is moving. There's no way I would remain the same boring version of myself. Like, I want to be interesting. I want to be a character. I want people to meet me and say, oh my God, you're really cool. Yeah, because I was never like that before. I changed. I pushed myself to change and become something different. Like, that's the whole point, actually. Evolution. You know, I'm evolving. I'm becoming a better version of myself every day. So when I see these people... Oh my God, I'm cooking spicy food and the chili is choking me. So anyways, what I'm saying is, that's probably why, you know, I'm not friends with you anymore. Like you did, you just never changed. You stayed the same boring version of you that I knew when I was your age, when we were the same age. Like, obviously I'm gonna change, but if you refuse to change, then you're not gonna be, nobody's gonna be surprised when they bump into you. Like for me, when I'm just doing my thing and somebody comes into my DM and he's like, oh my God, I went to high school with you. Do you remember me? I'm like, yeah, of course I remember you. And then they'd be like, oh my God, you've changed, blah, blah, blah. Like that was high school. I was lame as fuck in high school. And then I glowed up in uni and then I found myself. You know, I've been trying to find myself. So, I don't know, guys. I just feel like it's really, like, yeah, people change. I change. I might shave off my head tomorrow. I might get a tattoo finally. I might do something. I might add more piercings. Like, I have to change myself. And people don't understand. Like, it's very painful to realize that you need to change yourself because you're so boring at the moment. So yeah, that's the whole point of changing. You know, you're evolving, you're looking for who you truly are. Deep down in your heart, you know, this is not me. But when you refuse to grow out of that cocoon, that eggshell that you are stuck in since kindergarten, then you become very boring. Like, what happened to you? Why did we talk about all that stuff? Like, this is even the funniest part. Like, I had solid friendships, very solid friendships. I've always had solid friendships, very solid, like this. They carried weight. They defined my life. They made me who I was because of the influence that I was going with, you know, going through around these people. You get? So before you fall out with somebody, just know that friendship was really solid. Because you can't fall out with somebody that you don't take seriously, you don't even check up on, you don't care, like, you know. So all these friendships, I remember the solid ones, and all these friendships, there was always something about that person that I really liked. And for me, I think everyone that I ever got close with, I saw their vision. I saw their vision. Get? I was like, yeah, whatever you're saying you're gonna be, I can see it in you, you're gonna be. But then they stopped looking for that thing, and then they became stuck, you know. And who can you blame? You can't blame nobody, you have to blame yourself. So it's really important for people to break out of their cycles. I don't do more than 2 years. Like, 2 years is my, 3 years, let me say max 3 years. If I'm doing something for 3 years or 2 years and it's not working out, or I'm tired of it, it's now boring, I don't feel the vibe anymore, I cut it off. I move to the next thing. And yeah, so people like me who just, you know, we dead shit when shit needs to be deaded, we tend to grow and evolve and become different every time. And for me, I just want to say, when I have the money, I'm talking about when I have $100K, $200K, $300K, half a million, I am going to be, I'm going to be up there. Like, I would be rocking hair every day. I would have a hairstylist, a makeup artist, a wardrobe stylist, a publicist. I would have paparazzi. I would have all of that. All of it in one. God. Anyways, let me go back to my food. Living, the kitchen is very ugly looking. Oh, oh my God. Anyways, it's a Friday, no, it's a Saturday morning, and I woke up with a hangover because I drank some gin last night. I cannot come and kill myself. So now, so now it's time to eat the poor people's shit. Ramen noodle. This is like a ramen. Ramen noodle. Names. You guys have gained weight. It's very clear that I've gained some weight. Look at my face, very shabby. Very chubby, but I promise you guys, yeah. I let myself go, okay? I was struggling, I wanted to quit stuff. So, of course I'm going to struggle with something. And this is the problem with addictions, okay? When you quit one, you become addicted to the other one. So while I was, detoxing from food, no, detoxing from smoking and drinking, I became obsessed with food. Food never tasted so good. And I kept eating it and eating it and eating it. Ah, big. Food is life. So, excuse my dirty kitchen, right? I'm really hungry and I need to eat like some noodles before I faint. Because I need energy to clean up. I need energy to clean up. So I'm just going to do 1.5. Huh. I'm gonna break this in half and add it to my other one. I'm going to my husband, Hey, I don't have a husband, but I know I am going. Oh my God. Ooh. Oh my God, I dropped something. And the hot water is hot, team. See, that was a mistake. Oh my God, I just did that in camera. Anyways, guys, this is gonna choke me even more. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna have to cover the lid. Kidogo. See, I have the mop there. I'm gonna clean up, okay? I'm not a shabby girl. I'm a clean girl, okay? Yeah, so. Oh my God, I'm going to sneeze the hell out. I'm already coughing and I'm gonna add some more extra chilies. I don't know, I just can't eat bland, boring food. Like, it has to be spicy. Like, very spicy. I'm just used to it. You know, I trained myself to accommodate hot, spicy foods, and it has become that way since. So I'm gonna start the cleaning while my food is cooking, because that's the best way to like train yourself to not be lazy. As you're waiting for your food, you clean up. So I'm just gonna start by wiping. And removing. This goes to the trash bin. It's empty. Like, I'm not one of those girls who has like organizers yet. Maybe that's something I'll do later. But right now, I'm just living life. I'm not gonna pressure myself because of aesthetics and whatnot. Aesthetic requires money. And if you don't have the money for it, then you're just gonna look like everybody else. So yeah, everyone needs money to do the aesthetic stuffs. Put it here. Matchbox, Akashenda. Okay guys, thank you for sticking by. Let me show you guys what my noodle look like.
Alright, my BTD gang, thank you for stopping by. I am so grateful if you have stayed till the end of this vlog.
I am gonna go ahead and continue vlogging while having fun. Excuse the video, I knew I was gonna put a voiceover over this one, that's why I'm doing weird gestures and whatever. Anyways, thank you for supporting me.
I'm the only thing hopping like a kangaroo. I mean, the only thing popping like a cannibal. Listen, you should buy a 16 cause I write it good. The 808 wolf wolf cause I write it good. And bitches can't find a man cause I write it good. I'm the wolf, where is that I write it good? See it, it be really good.